4 আজ আমরা পড়ব রবি এন্ড দা উইপিং প্রিন্সেসের পার্ট 2 আর পড়ছে মন দিয়ে শুনো রবি ran straight up to his room he was very excited he opened the metal box and emptied the stamps onto the floor with the album beside him robi began to sort out all the stamps it was raining hard robi heard the front door bang and jumped up to look out of the window he was uncle mike running towards his car as uncle mike drove away he looked up and waved at robi robi smiled and waved back robi returned to his stamps there were all kinds of stamps big ones small ones stamps with postmarks and some without there were stamps with pictures of people's faces and some of birds and animals there were stamps from england japan malaysia china the usa and lots of the other countries there were some stamps from countries that robi had never even heard of But Robi was not looking very carefully at the stamps because all he could think of was the weeping princess. When he had sorted the stamps into little piles on the floor, he got some envelopes. On each envelope, he wrote in neat letters the name of a country and then put the stamps of that country into it. The ones he did not know, he put in a large brown envelope. On it he wrote, "Ask Uncle Mike." At lunch time, Robi's father asked, "How did you get on with your stamps this morning, Robi? Did you find any interesting ones?" "Oh yes," replied Robi. "There are lots of very interesting stamps in the box, but no weeping princess. I am going to look at the album after lunch." There are lots of old envelopes at the back of the album. They have stamps on them. You will have to be careful when you take them off the envelope, said Robi's father. Don't pull them off, but leave them so soft in some water. Then they will come off easily and won't be damaged. After lunch, Robi went back to his room. The rain had stopped, but Robi did not feel like playing football. Anyway, the ground would be very wet because the shower had been quite heavy. Robi picked up the album and turned the pages slowly. Some of the pages were loose because the album was very old. On each page, there were about 9 or 10 stamps. Some pages had only 2 or 3 stamps on them. Robi soon found out that this was because they were arranged in sets. On each page, at the bottom, in very neat writing, there was something written about the stamps. Robi looked at the stamps in the album and wondered how long Uncle Mike had taken to collect so many stamps. When he had finished looking at the album, he took out the envelopes that were at the back. Most of the envelopes were old and faded. The addresses written in ink were very pale. Robi could only just read what they said. He could see that the envelopes were addressed to Master Michael Davidson. Robi wondered who that was. Many of the envelopes had Canadian stamps on them. Robi tried to read the postmarks. He suddenly had a brilliant idea. He went to his shelf and picked up the magnifying glass that his father had given him for his birthday. Now I will be able to see the stamps, the addresses, and the postmarks quite clearly, he said to himself. He held up an envelope and looked through the magnifying glass. Toronto, he read. That must be a Canadian village or town. He opened the envelope and found a letter in it. He took the letter out and just as he was going to start reading it, he remembered what his parents had once said to him. Don't letter aside their royal letters in some of the other envelopes. But Robby did not read those. He made a pile of letters on the floor. He decided that he should give them to Uncle Mike when he saw him again. As Robby was pulling out another letter, a few stamps fell onto the floor. He picked them up and looked at them. Suddenly he leaped into the air shouting, "The weeping princess!" He looked carefully at the stamps in his hand and then looked at it again with the magnifying glass. Just then the door opened and Robby's mother came quickly into the room. "Robby," she said, "are you all right? I heard you shouting." "Look, mother," said Robby, "I think I have found the weeping princess." Robby's mother examined the stamps and said, "I think you may be right. Perhaps Uncle Mike will be able to tell you." Robby raced out of the room, holding tightly onto the stamp. "What's the matter?" asked Robby's father as Robby came stumbling down the stairs. Robby did not stop but shouting as he went past, "I have found the princess." He ran straight out of the front door and down the road. Robby's father shouted after him, "Don't drop her," and went back to reading the Sunday paper. Half an hour later, Robby and Uncle Mike arrived at the house in the old Austin. Robby was so excited that he did not wait. He ran into the house and told his father, "It is the weeping princess at least." Uncle Mike thinks it is. There is a tear on her cheek. Robby's father laughed. "Now just slow down, Robby. If Uncle Mike thinks it is the weeping princess, I am sure he is right." When Uncle Mike came into the room, everyone was smiling. Uncle Mike said, "I have had this stamp for all these years and I never knew. Now that I have given the album to Robby, it belongs to him. I think that Robby should keep the stamp and I hope he finds many more rare stamps." Robby was overjoyed. He stood there with a big smile on his face. With one hand he held onto his mother's side and in the other he held a white envelope. In it was the weeping princess. তাহলে আমরা কি পড়লাম যে রবি ছুটে তার রুমে গিয়ে মেটাল বক্সের স্ট্যাম্পগুলো মেঝের উপর ছড়িয়ে দিয়েছিল। তারপর সে দেখলো যে আঙ্কেল মাইক চলে যাচ্ছে। তার কাছে নানা ধরনের স্ট্যাম্প ছিল। স্ট্যাম্পগুলোকে খামে ভরে তাতে দেশের নাম লিখেছিল, কিন্তু একটা অজানা ছিল বলে সে সেখানে সেই তার স্ট্যাম্প খামের উপরে লিখে দিয়েছিল যে আজ আঙ্কেল মাইক। রবির বাবা রবিকে স্ট্যাম্পগুলো যত্ন করে রাখতে বলেছিলেন। রবি অ্যালবামের পেজগুলো আস্তে আস্তে করে খুলেছিল, কারণ পেজগুলো অনেক দিনের পুরনো অ্যালবামটা ছিল, তাই পেজগুলো লুজ ছিল। তাই সে দেখলো যে খামগুলোতে মাস্টার মাইকেল ডেভিডসনের ঠিকানা আছে। রবি পোস্টমার্ক দেখার জন্য আদর্শ কাজ ব্যবহার করেছিল। রবি কিছু খামগুলো খুলে দেখেছিল যে সেগুলোর ভেতরে চিঠি আছে, কিন্তু সে চিঠিগুলো পড়লো না, কারণ তার বাবা বলেছিল যে অন্যের চিঠি পড়তে না। রবি মেঝের উপরে পড়ে থাকা চিঠিগুলো এক জায়গাতে জড়ো করেছিল এবং সে ভেবেছিল যে আঙ্কেল মাইকের সঙ্গে দেখা হলে সে সেই চিঠিগুলো আঙ্কেল মাইককে দেবে। তারপর হঠাৎ সে আতস্কা দিয়ে উইপিং প্রিন্সেসের স্ট্যাম্পটা দেখতে পেল। তা দেখে সে চিৎকার করে উঠেছিল। তার চিৎকার শুনে তার মা তার রুমে এলো। তো রুমে এসে তার মাকে বললো, তার বাবা মা দুজনেই খুব খুশি হলো পেয়েছে বলে। তারপরে রবি ছুটে গিয়ে আঙ্কেল মাইক তখন চলে গেছে, কিন্তু এমন দেশে আঙ্কেল মাইককে বলার জন্য সে ছুটে গিয়েছিল। তারপরে 30 মিনিট পরে রবি আঙ্কেল মাইকের সঙ্গে ফিরে এসেছিল এবং সবাই আনন্দে হাসি খুশিতে ছিল এবং আঙ্কেল মাইক বলে যে রবিগুলো এই রবির এই স্ট্যাম্পগুলো রবির কাছেই থাক এবং রবি আরও রেয়ার যে স্ট্যাম্পগুলো আছে যেগুলো সহজে পাওয়া যায় না সেগুলো কালেক্ট করবে। এটাই তোমাদের পড়া, ভালো করে।